criminals, innocent agent liberals, rescued us from all our foes. Alleluia, alleluia, widely yet his mercy flow. Angels in the height adore him, ye behold him face to face. Sun and moon bow down before him, dwellers all in time and space. Alleluia, alleluia, praise with us the God of grace.
Amen.
Amen.
Let us pray. Our Father in heaven, we thank you for another opportunity we have to come before you to listen to your word and to pray. Lord, we thank you for giving us this great privilege to come to you, to listen to your word, and also to pray to you. We pray, Jesus, that you be with us this hour.
Amen.
That you bless our heart with your word.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Today is Children's Day. We pray, Jesus, that you bless our children.
Amen.
That you move them forward in life.
Amen.
Make them to grow in grace.
Amen.
They will grow in wisdom,
amen,
knowledge, and understanding.
Amen.
We pray, Jesus, that you bless their hearts as they grow in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you so much for what you are going to do.
Amen.
At this time, we remember those that are looking up to you for children. We pray, Jesus, that you give them wonderful children in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We pray that you make them to rejoice and to praise your name for the gift of children you are going to give unto them.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you so much for what you are going to do.
Amen.
We are all before you this evening. We pray that you bless us, you bless our heart.
Amen.
And as we call upon you, you answer our prayers.
Amen.
We pray, Jesus, that you bless our nation, Nigeria. You will bless the nations of the world. And you will make this plague of coronavirus to cease and to stop in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let everything we do here today be to the glory of your name.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus, for what you are going to do.
Amen.
Jesus, be lifted up.
Amen.
As we call upon you.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Jesus, I don't know what you are passing through. There's only one person that knows what you are passing through, and that's Jesus. He wanted to tell it to him. Tell it to Jesus in 419.
Stand to Jesus, are you grieving over your departed? Tell it to Jesus alone. Tell it to Jesus, tell it to Jesus, he is a friend that we know. You've no other such a friend or brother, tell it to Jesus alone. Do not yet slow down your cheeks unbidden. Tell it to Jesus, tell it to Jesus. Have you seen that to men eyes are hidden? Tell it to Jesus alone. Why don't you tell it to Jesus? Tell it to Jesus. He is a friend that we know. You've no other such a friend or brother. Tell it to Jesus alone. Do you fear the gathering cloud of sorrow? Tell it to Jesus. Tell it to Jesus. Are you anxious? What shall be tomorrow? Tell it to Jesus alone. Oh, why don't you tell it to Jesus? Tell it to Jesus. He is a friend that we know. You've no other such a friend or brother, tell it to Jesus alone. Are you troubled, had a thought of dying? Tell it to Jesus, tell it to Jesus, for Christ coming, kingdom high you sighing. Tell it to Jesus alone. Why don't you tell it to Jesus, tell it to Jesus, he is a friend I will know. You've no harder such a brother.
Let's sing the chorus for the last time.
Oh, oh, why don't you tell it to Jesus? Tell it to Jesus. He is a friend I will know. You've no harder such a friend or brother. Tell it to Jesus alone.
Amen.
Like the woman at the well, I was seeking for things that could not satisfy. And then I heard my Savior speaking, draw from where that never shall run dry.
Fill my cup, Lord.
May 27th, of course, May 27th of every year is the Children's Day, right? Yes. Hello, children.
Hello,
sir. So, being Children's Day, we are here at Safe Harbor Baptist Children's Home permanent site that is under construction. We've been here since morning to have a picnic set up with our children, hence. And since there's lockdown, no opening of church, we've been having Wednesday and Sunday evening services at Safe Harbor, where we are using currently, where we are living in currently, Safe Harbor Baptist Children's Home. And so we have network problem, internet problem here today. So hence all this temporary setup. So, but we give glory to God. So happy Children's Day to all our children.
Amen.
Another thing is Pastor Joseph Popola always preaches on Wednesday's evening, but he's not with us here today. He's gone to Lagos. His mom died on Monday, and he had to go to Lagos to be with his family and to get the burial done. So we pray God we grant him favor and Amen. Provide for every need for the family. So I think it right. Okay, I'm going to preach, and I hope I will not be too long. And if I'm too long, glory to God.
Amen.
That's what God wants to be, but I don't think so. Joshua chapter 1, there's something that was repeated and repeated and repeated to Joshua that I believe is very needed, even in this present world. It's not common again. It's not common again. It's not common again. So, Joshua chapter 1, verses 1 to 9 is the story base. Let's stand up as we honor the reading of God's word. I will read quickly, and then I will bring one or two points that God has laid on our hearts. Joshua chapter 1. Verse 1 to verse 9. So you read along with me silently while I read out. So now, after the death of Moses, the servant of the Lord, it came to pass that the Lord spake unto Joshua, the son of Nun, Moses' minister, saying, Moses, my servant, is dead. Now, therefore, arise, go over this Jordan, thou and all these people, unto the land which I do give to them, even to the children of Israel. Every place that the sole of your foot shall tread upon, that have I given unto you, as I said unto Moses. Verse 4, from the wilderness and this Lebanon unto the great river, the river Euphrates, all the land of the Hittites, and unto the great sea toward the going down of the sun, shall be your coast. Therefore shall not any man be able to stand before thee all the days of thy life. As I was with Moses, so I will be with thee. I will not fail thee, nor forsake thee. Be strong and of good courage, for unto these people shall thou divide for an inheritance this land, which I swear unto their fathers to give them. Only be thou strong and very courageous, that thou mayest observe to do according to all the law, which Moses my servant commanded thee. Turn not from me to the right hand or to the left, that thou mayest prosper whithersoever thou goest. This book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth, but thou shalt meditate therein day and night, that thou mayest observe to do according to all that is written therein. For then thou shalt make thy way prosperous, and thou shalt have good success. Have I not commanded thee? Be strong and of a good courage. Be not afraid, neither be thou dismayed. For the Lord thy God is with thee, whithersoever thou goest. Let us pray. Father, thank you for your word tonight.
Amen.
Bless us as we read, study, share the thoughts you've given us with your people tonight. May we be truly blessed.
Amen.
And Lord, may we be doers of your word.
Amen.
Thank you, Father.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
I love this passage. We all know we've all heard about Joshua. Joshua was a disciple in church language, was a disciple of Moses. He understudied Moses. He was always there with Moses. He was his PA, personal assistant. Wherever Moses went, Joshua was there with him. In fact, God directed Moses to train Joshua to take over after he was gone. So the transition was already set by God. And at the beginning of this story, we read and heard how Moses had gone. And now Joshua is in charge. One of the challenges of transition in any organization or administration or any given work is the transition, the stress of the acceptance of the people for the new leader or of the new leader. Most of the time, people that were there working with the previous leaders, they had their loyalties, their faithfulness set to or with the previous leaders. I remember when I was taking over from Pastor Amos, my mentor, one of the fear was with the people that we were working together with him. Now that he has set me to be the one to take over after he was gone, will they accept me? Will they give me the same cooperation they gave him? And of course, I give glory to God that they did. But I could feel and I understand personally what Joshua must be feeling here. And we'll say what that God repeated to Joshua that really prompted, showed me that he was really feeling fearful, dismayed, agitated. And in life, we always feel like that too, especially in the case of transition. But generally, with what is going on currently in this world, with this crisis, the problem of the world, we are always agitated. We are always fighting an uphill task, uphill battle. In life, generally, with population explosion, chances, opportunities are not as readily available as they. I remember in the days of our fathers, they said, even if you had high school diploma, high school certificate, you will get good job immediately, right? Yeah. Now, even if you have master's degree, you can hardly get good job. So to you children, being your day, this may cause agitation as you grow. Graduate, some of you will be graduating from high school very soon. You get to higher institution, and you look at the chances ahead. You look at the opportunities ahead. You feel, wow, I do not stand a chance. I don't think I can be successful. But now I want to give you one of the keys to success. And throughout the Bible is full, giving us keys we must possess to open doors that lead to success. I think I've shared over the time past with us about one of the keys to success, being faithfulness, right? I've spoken about humility. And from the lecture given to us today by Otumba Tayo Ojo, he really went deep on social work platform and so on. And he told us about dexterity, right? Being fearless. He gave us a lot of qualities that will help you children as you step out as adults in the near future. You step out into the world. And may I say to you, you have to face and fight for opportunities out there. And he has given us different keys that would help us to have advantage. And these are biblical keys. So tonight, let me give you another key that is, it was mentioned in another word. I was trying to remember this vocabulary used. But The key is courage. Courage is one of the keys to being successful in life. And this is a common desire within everyone to be successful. And when you look at the definition of the word to success, it's not the same as the Bible definition. Somebody said he was looking in a bookstore and he saw a writer. I won't mention the author, but he said, how to succeed in life. Wow. Even in the churches today, pastors, if care is not taken, we are becoming just motivational speakers without in-depth biblical principles. And so what I want to give you tonight is biblical principles of the key, courage to success. It's one of the key. What the Bible says, how to be successful. And taking one of the keys, courage, as focus tonight. So in this circular book, How to Succeed in Life, said the person listed about 6 steps. He said we become what we think about, which is noticing. Decide exactly what you want. Determine the price you have to pay. Commit to pay the price. Work hard one day at a time. Never give up. Well, those principles alone, they are not bad. They are not bad. But what you think that you want to become cannot just be anything. That's where they got it wrong. It must be what is biblical.
Amen.
Anything that is against the principle of the word of God, don't even think you want to become that. Or anything, any pursuit in life, children, that will make you not to follow God, that will lead you away from God, don't pursue it. You may be successful in that line according to the standards of the word, but to God, you are a failure. Because let me give you success to God. When God sees you as a successful people, by a person. By the way, in the world today, we have a lot of unbelievers, worldly people that are deemed successful. But to God, they are not. They are not. So I'm not saying you are looking and aspiring to the standard of the world, but you must aspire to the standard of the word of God.
Amen.
Because the word may say someone is successful, but to God they are not. The only thing for me and to me, I know I'm successful when I get to God after leaving this world. And even now that the Spirit of God keep on ministering, bearing witness with my witness, with my spirit, as the Bible says, that I know God is saying, well done, thou faithful and good servant. Success is when God says well done. If the whole world says well, the whole world says well done, and God says, ooh, you have failed. God said you are a disobedient servant, you have safely failed. So success to a child of God is aspiring to always please God. And when you are pleasing God, you are successful. And of course, this may lead to financial breakthrough, glory to God. This may lead to having good job, glory to God. This may, underline that, to other good things in life, glory to God. And if it doesn't lead to this, glory to God. As long as you are pleasing God. But our God is good. And I believe God wants good things for us, his children. So even when you aspire to please God, God will bless you with good things. No matter the challenges of life, God will always come through for you. Amen.
Amen.
So, having said this, God's standard of success is pleasing God. And it works. The pathway to success cannot be traveled by anyone who does not practice God's formula for success. And this is the principles we see in places, many places in the Bible, and for example tonight in Joshua chapter 1. Actually from verse 9 to verse 6, you will notice in verses 6, 7, and 8, one of the formulas for success, actually, as the Bible puts it in our text, is courage. It said, be strong and courageous. And when you look in verse number 6, it started, said, be strong and of a good courage. Verse 7, only be thou strong and very courageous. And verse 9, haven't I commanded thee, be strong and of a good courage? But I like it the way it put it together, because you need to, where did I see success and courage? But look at verse 8. It said, this book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth, but thou shalt meditate therein at night, that thou mayest observe to do according to all that is written therein. For then shalt thou make thy way prosperous, and then shalt thou have success. And when you look, what it means by following the will of the word of God is God's principle. Doing what God says you will build will result to prosperity and good success. I wonder, is there a bad success?
Right.
Yes, that is worldly. But good success is that which is of God. Amen.
Amen.
So verse 8 is saying, when you follow God's principles, God's outlines in life, for your life, you will be prosperous as God is concerned, and you will have good success. And one of the principles in this passage is courage. What is courage? It is the quality of mind or spirit that enables a person to face difficulty, to face danger or pain. Think about that. But you are talking about prosperity. You are talking of difficulty, danger, and pain. Yes. Because that's part of life. Say you face difficulty, danger, pain, etc. without fear. It means bravery. I think Otumba used that too. That was the word. Bravery. You have to be brave. It is to act in accordance with one's belief. And I love that. And this dictionary definition. The courage is you act in accordance with your belief, especially in spite of criticism. And this is what we need, children, today. To stand firm on what is right, what is godly, and not be ashamed. The world today, in this culture of woke culture. How many of you understand what woke culture means? It's the internet phenomenon, where people target you on social media and lambast you and criticize you and destroy you. And it's common among teenagers and younger people, mostly. Anything you say, somebody will say is bad. And a lot of people will begin to troll you, to shame you. And I'm telling you, if you go online today, in average way, and say that homosexualism is sinful, which is against the word of God, then woke culture will begin to go against you. In many developed countries now, they may even, somebody may charge charge you to court. May sue you, that's the word I want to get. Sue you to court for human rights violation, for hate crime. If you say that virginity is right and is glorious, it's what the Bible says, they begin to woke culture you. So you need courage to stand firm in accordance with your belief, Bible truth, no matter the criticism. It's called courage of conviction. You have strong conviction. Think about that. When David, in the valley of Elah, with his sling only, no warfare experience, had to face Goliath. If he was not courageous, do you think he could have even stepped out? Courage. What about Elijah when he challenged the prophet of Baal on Mount Carmel? He had courage. You see, children in life, you will face situations, crises, opportunities, difficult times in business, in family, in offices, in neighborhood. Actually, when you stand for God, somebody will stand against you who is not standing for God. And if you are not courageous, you will always chicken out. You need courage to stand for what is right, to keep standing for what is right. Don't let the world bully you. We live in the world of bully, children. It seems I'm, because being your day, I'm trying to focus it on you. Our children. Don't let the world bully you. Many of you in your high school, they bully you directly through pressure, peer pressure, they call it, into doing things that you know, you have read, you have seen in the word of God that is not right. Adam.
Amen.
Hello? Don't. And don't tell me, don't, let me tell you, we cannot protect you or keep you away. We cannot lock you down in the house 24/7. You will be exposed. You will get in touch with these people because you go to school. Some of you are getting to college. Some is already in college. Eh? Hello. Somebody is already, you're in college, university. Some are getting ready to go into college. And there's pressure on you. People enticing you, inviting you, challenging you to do the way of the world. Right? You need courage to stand firm. You need courage to stand for God, so that you will have good success. Courage is what we need for tomorrow. Amen.
Amen.
In Hebrews chapter 10, verse 32, the Bible said, "But call to remember the former days, in which after you were illuminated, ye endured a great fight of affliction." After you come to light, to know the truth. The Bible said that we live godly in this world, we suffer persecution, opposition, tribulation. We need courage. Children, you are growing up. You are going to the world. You're growing to adult. We can't provide everything, anything for you again. But we are hoping to God that what we have invested, planted into you, like it was said of Timothy, that from childhood he knew the scriptures. Abby?
Yes, sir.
He knew the scripture that's able to make one wise. That's why we keep teaching you in devotions, in church, in Bible clubs, in children, youth, single adult, teenager class. You are blessed.
Amen.
And when you get out there, the world will want you to chicken out. You need courage. But let me give you 2 points, briefly, that will help you to be courageous. You need courage to stand for the truth, the doctrine. You need courage to do your duties, what is right. You need courage to defeat your detractor. That's under full outline. I could go, but I'm not going there. We have little time. But let me give you 2 things that will help you. That will help you to say, I must be courageous because of, number one, be courageous because of the presence of God that is always with you. Because of the promise of his presence. Because of the promise of his presence. God has promised. Say, I will never leave you nor forsake you. When I'm not there as your father, earthly wise, God is always there.
Amen.
And that's what must help you to stand firm and not chicken out and not compromise. that my daddy is not here, my mommy is not here, they are not seeing me, but remember somebody is there. That is always there. And who is that person, children?
God.
Who is that person?
God.
God has promised. Look at verse 5 of that passage. I love it. It said, there shall not any man be able to stand before thee all the days of thy life. Why? As I was with Moses, so I will be
with thee.
God said, I will be with thee. And in the book of Hebrews, it tells us the same. I will never leave thee, nor forsake thee. Isaiah 43, verse 1 and verse 2. But now, thus said the Lord that created thee, O Jacob, and he that formed thee, O Israel, fear not, for I have redeemed thee, I have called thee by my name. Thou art mine. When thou passest through the waters, I will be, and through the rivers, they shall not overflow thee. When thou walkest through the fire, thou shalt not be burned, neither shall the flame kindle upon thee. Why? That is, any challenge of life, any opposition of life you face, yes, it will be tough. The one before Joshua in our text passage was enormous. Remember, it was among the 12 spies that went, and they saw the land, that it was walled. It has great fence for security. You remember that they said there were giants in the land. And if you remember what Joshua and Caleb, the two that stood for God, what they said during that time, did they come and say, no, you are telling lies. The cities were not walled. Did they say that? No. Did they say, no, you guys are telling lies. There were no giants there. No. They affirmed it. There were giants,
right,
and the cities were walled. But we have God.
Amen.
With us.
Preach.
So when you go out there, there are giants out there.
Hmm.
There are war cities out there.
Amen.
There are difficulties out there.
That's true.
But be courageous, because God is with you.
Amen.
I'm courageous today because God is with me.
Amen.
I don't know about tomorrow. But I know who holds tomorrow.
Amen.
And I know he holds my life. Because he lives, I can face tomorrow. My fear is gone. God is God. He's everlasting.
Amen.
See, the word of God is always here in amen. And you may look at, we are preaching the same thing from different angles. Because the word of God is true.
Amen.
It's yea. And amen.
Amen.
To be successful, children, you need courage. And what should help you to be courageous? Be courageous because you have God, the promise of God's presence with you. Say, I will never leave you nor forsake him. Hebrews chapter 13, verse 5. I quoted this some weeks ago. Let your conversation be without covetousness, and be content with such things as ye have. That's another preaching again. For he hath said, I will never leave thee, nor forsake thee. Yes, we can be courageous because of the promise of his presence. But the second one I will just share with you before we go to pray. Be courageous because of the provision of his power. The promise of his presence. Then provision of his power. Look at that verse 5 again of Joshua. They say, I will not fail thee, nor forsake thee. See, the idea with I will be with thee, not only be with thee, I will not fail thee. In other words, God said he will work for you, and you will not be disappointed. God is saying the secret to success is what he does and what he's doing in you and through you. The provision of his power. God's presence is simply the guarantee of his power. See, after crossing the Red Sea and the drowning of Pharaoh and the Egyptian, Moses and Israel sang unto the Lord. Listen to Exodus chapter 15 from verses 1 to 11. But look at verse 11 specifically. They said, who is like unto thee, O Lord? Among the gods, who is like thee? glorious in holiness, fearful in praises, doing. And we add that, and we have that chorus is, who is like unto thee?
Oh, Lord.
Sing, come on.
Who is like unto thee?
Oh, Lord.
Among the gods, who is like thee? Glorious in holiness and careful in praises. Do wonders, hallelujah.
He's the one that is doing wonders. He's the one that has the power. Amen. The power to heal, the power to help, the power to protect, the power to provide. He's the one. He's the one. Hallelujah.
Amen.
In Matthew chapter 28, verse 18, verses 18 to 20. We use this a lot as benediction in our church. He said, Jesus came unto them and said, and spake unto them, saying, all power is given unto me in heaven and there. Therefore, go ye into all the world and teach all nations, discipleship, witnessing, soul winning, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded you, and lo, I'm with you always. You remember the promise of his presence. And it is that promise of a presence that are starting to us of the provision of his power. His power is able, abundantly able, totally able. And we should be able to say like Paul, and with Paul, I can do all things. That is courage. I can do all things. In my own power, no. In my own wisdom, no. In my own ability, no. But I can do all things through Christ.
Amen.
Which strengthens me.
Amen.
I can do all things to Christ. That's courage. Children, whenever you are faced with opposition, with challenges, with difficulties, with projects like what Joshua faced, that was a serious project. He knew the land is what, he knew they had giants. But God said, don't worry. Remember faith, like you had when you went as one of the spies. Believe in me. Remember, I'm with you, and I will not fail you. I will do it for you. And that is what should help us to have courage. And that is what should give us courage. Children, mommies, daddies, uncles, aunties, we need courage as we step forward. We need to be able to boldly say, the Lord is with me. The Lord is for me. Who can be against me? 2 points. Hold it. Hold them, rather. Number one, the presence of God. The promise of his presence is for you. He's always with you. And the provision of his power. Everything you do and that you will do will be through God. Let us live here today with new zeal of courage. Let us be ready to face all obstacles and challenges because we know that God is with us and his power is for us. God bless you.
Amen. Amen.
Let us pray. Father, thank you tonight. We are so grateful for the word of God. Thank you for another nugget, another quality. You want us to hold firm to that will give us, make us prosperous and give us good success.
Amen.
And that quality is courage, that we should be strong and be courageous. God, help us to be courageous.
Amen.
To be valorous, to be brave.
Amen.
To have growth, a God, to have grit, to have backbone. To stand. To not let the word of God's commandment, the principle of the Bible, the word of God, do not let it depart from our mouth. Help us, O Lord.
Amen.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
In Jesus' name.
Amen. God